हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 6, कंस्ट्रक्शन इक्विपमेंट मैनेजमेंट। सो नाउ इन दिस चैप्टर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द कंस्ट्रक्शन इक्विपमेंट्स, सो विच आर यूज फॉर टू कंप्लीट द प्रोजेक्ट वेरी वेल। एंड हियर इन अ कंस्ट्रक्शन देर आर द मेन 4 M इज कंपल्सरी रिक्वायर्ड। फर्स्ट वन इज अ मटेरियल, सेकेंड इज अ मैन पावर, थर्ड वन इज अ मनी एंड फोर्थ वन इज अ मशीनरी। सो दिस 4 M इज इम्पोर्टेंट एम्स, 4 M। सो इन वन ऑफ द 4 M इज अ मशीनरी और इक्विपमेंट। सो इन दिस मशीनरी, फ्रॉम द मशीनरी वी कंप्लीट द वर्क वेरी फास्ट एंड क्वालिटी वर्क, वी गॉट अ क्वालिटी वर्क। So here introduction is given regarding the construction equipment. So here in this chapter we discuss about how to manage the equipment, and let's start with introduction. So construction equipment are one of the very important resource of the modern day construction, and equipment are utilized for most of the work, including earth moving operation, aggregate production, concrete production and its placement and so on. So here there are the different equipment is used, like in earthquake there are the different equipment used, like excavator, then after for compacting purpose road roller is required, then after for a lifting purpose crane is required. So these are the different machinery is used, like for a concrete mixing mixer machine is required, or for a ready mix concrete so RMC plant is compulsory required. So these are the different machinery used to prepare or to complete the work of the construction site. So one cannot think any major construction activity without construction equipment, like we construct a multi-story building, like 10-story building. So for lifting the material, it is difficult to lift the material by the manpower, is a very difficult and time consuming method. So for this we use the tower crane. So by using the tower crane we easily lift the material from ground floor from the ground to another floor, like on a 10th floor or a 15th floor, etc. So here there are the different type of the construction equipment suitable for a different activities in a construction project. So here different machineries available, and each machines work are different. So the choice of the construction equipment defined as a construction method, which in way lead to determination of a time and cost of the project. So here, like for excavation, if we select any area, particular area, and when we excavate the particular area by manually, so it's a time consuming and costly. As compared to this, if we use the excavator to excavate any particular area, so it's very less time consuming and complete the work on or before time, and it's a lower cost as compared to manually. Now next topic we start is classification of the construction equipment. So construction equipment have been classified in a various following ways, like on the basis of function and equipment performance. Second is on the basis of operation in which equipment is used, and third one is based on purpose, like a general purpose or a special purpose equipment. So these are the question asked in a GTO examination, like classify the construction equipment and explain analyze the construction classification and explain any one in a detail or a two in a detail. Now next here first one is a classification based on functions and equipment performance, like complete the work within 1 hour, complete the work within 2 hour, etc. So equipment performance is very fast or slow is dependency of the equipment. And second is on the basis of operation which the equipment is used. Like there are the different operation is there in a construction work, like excavation, then after concreting work, then after compacting work, then after vibrating work. So these are the different operations is there, and different equipment is required to complete the task. So and third one is based on purpose. So here in a general purpose and a special task, like in a general purpose, like if we construct a road, so road methodology for all the time are same, like a road we construct at on a village area or on a city area. So road construction methodology is same. So it's a general purpose. We use the excavator or a road roller, etc. Machinery are used. And another is a special purpose equipment. Like some of the time we construct a dam. So in a dam, it's a special equipment are required for a compacting, for a surface finishing, for a equipment lifting, etc. So here classification of the construction is different as per our requirement. Now next is a factor for selection of the equipment. So here there are the seven factor affect for select the equipment. So first one is the economic consideration. So like if we select any machinery, so it's economical for us. So if sometime we select a heavy machinery, so overall construction cost is increased due to selection of the construction equipment. So here like a small project work, so small project work, so small JCB is required, like excavator, small excavator is required, like in a large excavation area, so this type of the machinery is required. And as for time, as per the time, we also select the equipment, but it's economic for us. Sometimes not increase the overall cost as compared to targeted cost. Now next is a company specified. So there are the different companies are available in the market. So we use the different company, and maintenance of all the companies are different. Like look like a car. So there are the different cars is available in the market by different companies, and all the cars are maintenance cost is different. So it's also affect for the selection of the equipment. Like some of the equipment maintenance is very less as compared to another equipment, and some of the companies equipment maintenance is much more as compared to another equipment. Now next is a site specific. So here site is mostly affected, like site your selected site is on a hill area or a valley area or on a plain ground, plain terrain, etc. So it's a very difficult task to construct a building or any construction on a hill area. So it's equipment required for a particular site selection is difficult, and equipment used for the particular area is different. Now next is equipment specific. So in a some in a equipment specific, so there are the different operation is there in a construction work. So we select the particular task by the particular equipment. Next is a client and a project. So depend on a client and project. So project is there are the different type of the project, like a small project, large project, mini project, etc. So as per the size of the project, we select the equipment. And if the small project is that, so we use the small equipments to complete the task or work on a time. And if the project is large and heavy project, so as per the requirement, size of the equipment is increased. And next is a manufacturer. So here manufacturer is an important thing in a selection of the equipment. So like who is the manufacturer of the particular equipment? So as per the manufacturer, we decide the equipment quality and maintenance cost. And seventh one is a labor consideration. So in a labor consideration, so there are the if less number of the labor for a particular company, so we use the maximum use of the machinery to complete the work. And number of labor is higher as compared to another companies. And so at that time machinery is required less. So here depends on a size of the depend on number of the labors. So these are the different factors which one is a selection for the equipment. So like here different equipment listed is below, like earthquake equipment. So here backhoe is a description, and then after purpose. So for a backhoe, purpose to excavate the below the ground or a lower of the elevation. And application is cutting the trench and pits, etc., and leveling and loading. And second is a shovel or front shovel. So for the excavation above its own track or wheel level. So for a cutting and leading is the application. And here capacity is also given, like struck bucket capacity is 0.38 meter cube to 3.25 meter cube. Now next is a drag line. So purpose for a drag line is for a bucket bulk excavation in a loose soil below its own track level. And application is that for a canal and pits excavation, cutting and distilling of ditches. And it's only suitable for loose soil and marshy land and area containing water. And capacity for a drag line is a 0.38 meter cube to 3.06 meter cube. Then after, another equipment is a clamshell or a grab. So for a deep confined cutting in a pit trenches, and application is such as a shafts, pits and well, and concerned hydraulically controlled bucket suspended from the lift arm. And its capacity is 0.38 meter cube to 3.06 meter cube. So clamshell and dragline capacity is the same. Now next is a dozer. So for moving the earth up to distance above the 100 meter and shallow excavation, and acting as a trolling tractor. And the purpose of the scraper machine, and application for clearing and grubbing site and excavation of the surface earth and maintaining the roads. And can be track mounted or wheel mounted. And blade capacity is 1.14 meter cube to 6.11 meter cube. Similarly, earthquake equipment is a road roller or a compactor. So for compaction of the earth and other material, like we use the road roller for compacting bitumen, and used for the large work area like highway, canals, airports, etc. And comes in a different varieties, like a smooth wheel, vibratory roller, then after pneumatic tire roller, and sheep footer roller. Now next is a scraper. So here scraper is for the side stripping and leveling and loading, hauling and discharging over loading distance. And comes in a different varieties, such as a tower scraper and two wheel axle scraper and three axle scraper, and best suitable for a whole distance varying between the 150 meter to 900 meter. And size is different sizes available, like 8 meter cube to 15 meter cube. And next is a dumper. So dumper is generally used for horizontal transportation of the material on or off site. So suitable for hauling on softer subgrade large capacity dumper are used in a meet and queries and comes in a different variety with a front trip tipping side and elevator tipping arrangements. So load capacity of the 1 ton about the 80 ton to 20 ton is common for a small dumper and grader. So for spreading fill and file trimming subgrade and grader performs follow-up operation of a scraping bulldozer and grading and finishing the upper surface of the earthen formation and embankment, and a grader usually operated in a forward direction only. So these are the earthwork equipment. Now next, another equipment is concreting equipment. So like a concrete batching and a mixing plant, concrete mixture, and for weighting and mixing large quantity of the concrete construction, and its capacity is 20 meter cube to 250 meter cube, and concrete mixture. So for mixing the small quantity of the concrete constituents, and capacity up to the 200 liter per batch, and small mixture and between the 200 and 750 liter per batch for a large mixture, and concrete transit mixture. So it's for a transport the concrete from batching plant. So its capacity is 3 meter cube to 9 meter cube, and concrete pumps static or portable. So for a horizontal and vertical transportation of the large volume of the concrete in a short duration, and its construction can be accessed in a 120 meter cube per hour specialized construction in industry. So here different equipment photograph is there. So this photograph is tower crane. So like a top slabbing tower crane, here hook is provided for lifting the material, and here control cabin is there. So tower crane height is we easily increase or decrease as per our requirement. Second is a tower crane is a bottom slaving. So in a bottom slaving, tower crane is rotated from the bottom, clear? So here tower crane is look like a top slaving, but here rotation is at a bottom, and a control cabin is here. So in a simple top slaving tower crane, controlling is at a top side, and in a bottom slaving tower crane, control is at a bottom side. Next is a lattice boom truck mounted. So here boom truck mounted, so here crane hook is provided, and boom is provided. So it's mounted on a truck, and easily this crane is easily transported from one place to another place for lifting the material purpose. Next is a telescopic boom truck mounted. So here name indicate telescope. So here in a telescope, inner and outer circular hollow pipe is moving inside and outside. So it's a telescope, and a broom truck mounted means here this crane is mounted on a truck. Next is a crawler crane. So here chain is provided at the bottom side in place of the tire, and here boom is provided and hook is provided for lifting the material. And this crawler crane is generally used in heavy construction sites. Next is a rough terrain mobile crane. So it's a small type of the mobile crane is there, and it's generally used in a industrial area for lifting purpose. And next type of the all-terrain mobile crane. So here look, this mobile crane look like a telescopic mobile mobile crane. So here telescopic crane and all-terrain mobile crane both are look like look wise same, but capacity is less as compared to telescopic mobile crane. Now in the next lecture we discuss about the depreciation of the machinery. Now we here stop our lecture. Thank you.